Welcome to Live from the Grand Teton Music Festival from Jackson Hole, Wyoming. Each summer, the Grand Teton Music Festival takes place in the Teton Mountains of Wyoming. Led by Maestro Donald Runnicles, the renowned festival orchestra consists of the world's finest players from more than 90 ensembles around the world. The international audience is unique as well. They may hike, bike, or sightsee during the day, but they also come to Jackson for the evenings for some of the finest music making anywhere, the Grand Teton Music Festival. I'm Jeff Counts, General Manager of the festival, and I'd like to introduce you now to my friend and co-host, Music Director Donald Runnicles.
Thank you, Jeff.
Great to be with you, Donald. Donald, in this episode of Live from the Grand Teton Music Festival, we have just one very large indeed piece, the Fantastic Symphony, the Symphonie Fantastique of Hector Berlioz. You said something to me the other day, Donald, that reminded me that this piece, we're talking about the perspective of the history, the evolution of the symphony. This piece was written in 1830. That is only 6 years after the completion of Beethoven's Ninth Symphony. I don't know about you, but in those 6 years, I hear centuries, not years.
Yes, I agree. There is no organic transition from Beethoven's Ninth Symphony to what was effectively Berlioz's First Symphony. One has the feeling that even though he was really autodidactic, I mean, he didn't have any great formal training, Hector Berlioz, there was something in that man, there was genius in that man. It wasn't just where he took the symphonic form into this programmatic masterpiece, but where did he take the orchestra? Where did he have this imagination to quite literally create new instruments for his orchestra? And of course he went on to write what was then one of the greatest treatises on how do you orchestrate, how do you transform something from the piano, and where did this all come from? Well, before I try to describe the indescribable, Berlioz himself provided the following note. This was to the audience at the first performance of 1830. The composer's intention has been to treat various states in the life of an artist insofar as they have musical quality. Since this instrumental drama lacks the assistance of words, an advance explanation of its plan is necessary. First movement, daydreams, passions. The composer imagines that a young musician troubled by that spiritual sickness which a famous writer has called le vague des passions. The composer imagines that a young musician troubled by that spiritual sickness which a famous writer has once called the intimations of passion sees for the first time a woman who possesses all the charms of the ideal being he has dreamed of and falls desperately in love with. She becomes associated with what we call this idée fixe, which is a leading motif that we hear in all of the movement. And this moves from this idée fixe, this woman, this fixation moves from that first movement. There's tenderness, there's tears, there's jealousy. It leads us to the second movement, a ball. The artist is placed in the most varied circumstances, amid the hubbub of a carnival, in peaceful contemplation of the beauty of nature. But everywhere in town, in the meadows, the beloved vision appears before him, bringing trouble to his soul. There's then the scene in the country. There is the march to the scaffold, where he suddenly imagines that this woman is no longer in love with him. He takes all sorts of concoctions, opium, and through that has these weird, horrific hallucinations, and imagines that he's actually poisoned his beloved and he's been taken to the scaffold to be condemned to death. We hear him just before he does die, just that final image, that final few notes of the idée fixe. And then, of course, the final movement, the dream of a witch's Sabbath, where he now sees himself at the witch's Sabbath, this ghastly crowd of spirits, sorcerers, strange noises, everything we could possibly imagine. I mean, this colossal bell that was built specially for the performance. And she, the idée fixe, mixes in with this devilish orgy. And I mean, this work, no wonder people loved it in the 1960s. 1968, it really is high. It's, we know the composer himself.
He wasn't guessing about that.
He wasn't guessing. He knew. Clearly imbibed. He knew. He went places that not many other people in his generation went to, and yet was in a position then to, so to speak, come back and put this music down. And I think to this day, this is, gosh, you know, 1830, and this is 2022. None of its originality, none of its outrageous creativity for me ever wears off. It just is one of those works that remains completely and utterly fresh.
It's worth commenting a little bit about Berlioz the man, because I think his fixations went a large way towards creating this incredibly unique and incredibly personal sound world. He won the Prix de Rome in 1830 as well, and part of winning that prize is to have a residency in Rome. Though this music, Symphonie Fantastique, is very likely about Harriet Smithson, the actor who he later married, there was another crush that he was nurturing when he went to Rome with a woman, a 19-year-old woman, Camille Moak. Their relationship didn't survive his Italian sojourn. In fact, she married Pleyel, the piano maker, and Berlioz was so upset by the betrayal that he had decided he was going to kill them both and himself, and made his way back to Paris, got as far as Nice before he talked himself out of it and returned to Rome. This is the kind of passion this man could muster. This is the kind of crazy he could muster. And I think you hear that in this music, even though it wasn't about that per se, it is about him. And he's in there.
Oh, totally. And imagine if he had followed up on that double murder. What would he have then written?
What would we be saying today? Well, let's listen now. We're in Walk Festival Hall in Jackson Hole, Wyoming. Music director Donald Runnicles has just taken the podium to lead his Grand Teton Music Festival Orchestra in Hector Berlioz's Symphonie Fantastique in five movements. Movement one, Daydreams, Passions. Movement two, A Ball. Three, Scene in the Fields. Four, March to the Scaffold, and five, Dream of a Witch's Sabbath.
Thank you. Thank you. We'll be right back. Thank you.
That was the incredible Symphonie Fantastique by Hector Berlioz. Maestro Sir Donald Runnicles led the Grand Teton Music Festival Orchestra in Jackson Hole, Wyoming at Walk Festival Hall. This has been a presentation of the Grand Teton Music Festival, located in Jackson Hole, Wyoming.
Live from the Grand Teton Music Festival is a co-production of the Grand Teton Music Festival and Classic Digital Syndications. Victor Munzer is our celebrated producer. Our recording engineers for the festival include Vic,
along with Roni Jules.
We would love to hear from you. Yes, you. Write to us, please. Simply send us an email to listener@gtmf.org, and by all means, come and visit us at the Summer Festival in Jackson Hole. For information about the festival, visit gtmf.org. I'm Donald Runnicles.
And I'm Jeff Counts. Thank you so much for being with us.